Hey everyone, I am Ishan and I am so excited today for this session. Today we'll be building something really amazing. It's a beginner project in machine learning. If you want to get started with machine learning, this is a great starting point for you. And with me today, I have my friend Prajwal Gupta. Hey Prajwal, how you doing, bro?
Hello, hello, good morning, bro. How are you?
I'm good. Today would be him just explaining to you how the Titanic dataset works, and he would actually be showing you an actual demo of how it works and what all can you do with it. Okay, so let's talk about the requirements that will be required for this particular project. Okay, so I have this doc. I've just written what all do you need. So you would really need to know how Python works, and that would be really important because again, we'll be using the syntax of Python a lot. Nothing too high level in Python, but it would be really advisable if you know the basic stuff in Python. And then you
Like
should
I've
also
tried to
be
keep it as basic as possible because logistic regression is one of the most basic models that you need to know to get started with machine learning. But everything just builds up from that. So today we have made it very simple with very less data processing. We'll try to create a model that's most effective.
All right. And so this is just a step that you can see on the screen of what all we'll be doing. First of all, we'll be doing logistic regression on the data set that we'll be downloading. So Titanic is a very famous data set. It's available on Kaggle. You can just go on to Kaggle and you can take a look at the data set
Search
over
Titanic
here.
data set.
Yeah, so this is a competition on Kaggle. So basically you can participate in this competition and you can use various formulas and methods to improve your accuracy of your data set. And so basically the competition here is to predict if a person would actually live or die in the disaster that happened with the Titanic. Okay, like you all might know what Titanic is, and the ship sunk, and because of that, a lot of people died. Okay, so this is the competition that you can see over here. You can just register and you can download the data set over here. This is the data. And so today that is what we'll be working on. As you can see, we have the training set over here, and we also have the test set. Okay, so we will be downloading the training set, and that you can just download by just registering over here and click on download. And so yeah, just you can just have a quick look at what all you can get from this data set. But for that, I'll just ask Prajwal to just explain us what this data set is about, and then we can start building upon this, right? So the number one step would be to download the data set, and then we'll talk about how can you use it and what environment do you need. Okay, so yeah, over to you, Prajwal.
Okay, so basically, Titanic dataset is the actual names and the passenger IDs and many other stuff of the people who were on board the Titanic. So they've created that data for all of us to basically work on. It's kind of like the hello world of machine learning. So it's the most basic thing that you need to learn to get started. And everything just builds over that. So today, we are going to use Google Collaboratory. So for the people who use Jupyter, and I think that's well enough. But basically, you need a good computational, basically at least 8 GB RAM. And I suggest people don't do machine learning if you have anything less than 8 GB RAM. Your computer will crash. I am guaranteeing that. If you ex like the Titanic dataset, it's okay. It's a very small dataset. But as you go bigger and bigger, you just need to press enter button, and your entire computer will just go. I'm sorry, not today. So use Google Collaboratory. It's actually in cloud computing, and you basically have 16 GB RAM and I think 8 GB GPU to work, and that's really, really impressive.
Yeah, so as you guys can see
So
on the screen, this is the Google Collab. It's really simple. You just need to log in, and here I already have a few notebooks over here. By the way, guys, as you can see, this is the .ipynb extension. Normally with Python files, you would be having a .py extension. This is just for the Jupyter notebook. Okay, so yeah, that's what we'll be doing. And okay, so you can just go on to Collaboratory, and here you can start, just coding and making your first machine learning model, right?
basically how Collaboratory works is in kernels. So what exactly is a kernel? I'll explain in a few minutes for those who are new. So should I present my screen?
Sure, bro.
Can you guys see?
Yep, I think we can see the screen. Guys, let us know if you can see the screen. I won't be able to read your comments, I think, but yeah, I can see it over here.
Okay, that's great. So basically what you see here is a kernel. So what a kernel is basically a way you can run mini text lines of code. So you can check with each line that if your code is correct or not. You don't need to write everything in one go and then run it. You can run mini code. Like you can run each line differently so you can check if there are any errors.
All right. Yeah.
So if you've downloaded the Titanet dataset, what you do is go in Google Colab, click on this folder and go on upload. And then from there, you can upload your train and your test dataset. So just select that and upload.
Right. So here, now, the dataset has been uploaded onto the cloud storage, right? On Google Colab.
Yeah. So Google Colab cannot access your desktop. So you need to upload it on the cloud so that Google Colab can access the dataset.
All right.
So as you can see left here, test CSV and the train CSV have been uploaded.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we should all start coding now.
Yep. Let's start.
Well, let me first explain what logistic regression is. It's basically a statistical model. Okay. So what logistic regression does is estimating the parameters. So for example, let us say that if a person has died or not, we can put 0 or 1 as their value, as 0 has not died and 1 has died. So what logistic regression does is it takes all of the different parameters like age or a physical class or from where did they come from, and basically use some weights or computational method to predict it to the best accuracy that whether that person is dead or not, basically 0 or 1,
yeah,
if you say it in a computer language. So today we'll be using two libraries, Python and sklearn.model processing for logistic regression.
So we're using sklearn and pandas, right?
Yeah, basically
okay,
sklearn and pandas.
All right,
so
go on.
We start by importing pandas. Import pandas as pd. Now, pd is something that is very dependent to a coder because you do not want to use pandas everywhere. Okay,
yeah.
So you import it as PD using short forms. Like import panda as PD. So you don't need to use pandas everywhere. You just use PD and then work with that. So let's run this cell. As you can see, it's done.
By the way, guys, now this is a way for you to just execute. These are cells. Okay, so this is different from most other editors and, just environments and IDEs. Here you have cells in which you will just write your code and then you can execute that particular code. Yeah.
Now let's just import our CSV file.
So over here, we're actually importing the test.csv file, right?
Yeah. So as you can see here, I didn't use pandas. I used the short form PD, which is very useful. As I told you before, that you always don't need to use pandas dot. You can just use pd dot. And read CSV is an attribute from which you can import a CSV into this name, Titanic.
Yeah.
Now you can change this name to anything you want. I am just kept it because I am comfortable with this nomenclature. You can keep it Titanic 2 or Train 2 or anything you want. It's just for one's own personal method. How does it do it? So you can run this cell. Now you can see it's run. If you see a number there, it means that the cell has run.
Okay.
Okay. So now what we do is we can see the shape.
What is the shape exactly?
Basically, it's the shape. It basically tells the rows and columns. So,
so this is a matrix, guys. If you don't know what a matrix is, it's just a way to represent a bunch of things. We have the rows and we also have columns. Okay, so
basically,
that's just
So also another shortcut, you can press Alt Enter to basically run that cell and create another cell.
Okay.
So it's a shortcut if you like.
Mm-hmm.
You can use Alt Enter instead of just running the cell. So now we are going to use an attribute of Titanic.
So what does 891 and 12 mean over here?
I will show it to you in a very short time. You will understand.
All right.
So if you use wrong name.
Titanic.head. Okay.
Yeah. So you see this? There are 12 columns and basically there are 891 roles. So we have 891 people that we know about that were on board the Titanic, and how they died or not, it's basically shown here.
All right.
So 891 is basically the number of people, and 12 is the information about them.
Okay.
So as you can see here, passenger ID, survival, P class, name, sex, age, ticket, fare, cabin, and embark.
Okay, so guys, these are all the attributes of every single person. So if they survived or not, in which class did they stay in the ship, what was their age like, you know, everything about them, we have a very organized way of just representing that in this data set. Yeah.
So this is basically data visualization. Hmm. Another way you can see this data is dot info.
Yeah.
Can just see which data type. It's an integer, so basically it's a number. And object is basically a string. A float is also a number, but it's in, I think, points, like here.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think first we should understand what each of this column means, because in machine learning we can't just blindly do anything to a data set. So we should first understand what the importance of each column does to a data. So let me just try to explain something to you. In your own head, try to understand whether a ticket number would affect the death of the person or not.
Yeah, that wouldn't make much of a sense, right?
And, also name. Name wouldn't basically affect his death, because the name could be anything. It could be arbitrary.
Yeah.
Also the fare. Fare he paid can also be an arbitrary. So it does not basically have any correlation with the data set.
Yeah, it's just about thinking, what do you think can actually result to him surviving or not, right? That could be the class, actually. Like if he is staying in the upper class, he is much more likely to survive than if he
because the upper class is in the front of the ship.
Yeah.
So the people who were in the back of the ship died first, because the ship sunk from the back.
Yeah.
You have to think things like this. Also, if we feed our machine learning what a garbage data, it will impact the accuracy a lot.
What is a garbage data, first of all?
Like name or ticket number. That's garbage data. It has no correlation. It has no meaning.
Okay.
So if we feed our model something that has no meaning, it is surely going to impact the accuracy. So you can all try with yourselves how to basically drop some data or add some data on your own to make the accuracy better.
All right.
Okay. So now we are going to process the data.
Okay. So now this is the next step, guys. In this step, we'll just be processing the data and we'll be making it better for the computer to process, right?
Yeah. So as you can see here, there's something known as embark. Okay. Embark is from, has three values, S, C, and Q. You can't see the Q value here, but if you scroll down enough, you can see the Q value. So basically, what is S, C, and Q? S is Southampton, Q is Queenstown, and C is Cherbourg. So basically, these are the name of the places that the people embarked from, or basically took the boat from.
Yeah.
Okay. Hmm. So that actually affects our data set a lot, because if the person didn't get into the boat at all, how would he die?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Now you have to understand one thing, that a machine learning model does not understand strings. It doesn't understand what is the meaning of S, C, or Q. So we need to basically process the data in such a way that it understands the meaning of S, C, and Q. So now we're going to use a very, very powerful feature of pandas known as dummies.
Dummies.
Okay. So what dummies does is basically, well, it will be better if I show you first.
Okay.
So let me just write this code. Now look at this. If you see here, the embarked value of 0 is S, right? Now, see here, Embark C is 0, Embark Q is 1, and Embark S is 1.
What does this really mean? But
Okay,
embark.
so it means that it has created dummies. So dummies are basically a way to represent data. So what it is doing is, instead of making a C as a string, like S, C, and Q, what it's doing is, if you see the C column and its value is 0, it means it's not C. If we go and see in Q, it is 0, it means not Q. And if it's 1, it means it is S. It's just a way to represent data. Okay, a computer cannot understand strings or literals. It needs to understand numbers. So we try to represent S, C, and Q as numbers. We can represent S as 001. And basic Q is represented as 010. And C is represented as 100.
All right.
It's like a binary representation, as we all do. Okay, like 1 can be represented as 001, or 2 can be represented as 010. Here, S is represented as 001, Q is represented as 010, and C is represented as 100. So it's just a way to represent something so that the computer can understand it.
All right.
Okay,
All
so
right.
dummies is a very, very powerful attribute of Pandas that is lets us extract data from strings.
Okay, bro.
Okay. So now what we are
By the way,
going to
guys,
do
if
is,
you're having any doubts, let us know in the chat and we'd be happy to answer them. I'm just going over through whatever you are asking, and so yeah.
now what we're going to do is, it now we have to join this ports dummy with the original data set. So Titanic dot join. Okay, we're going to join, wait, sorry, that's wrong. Titanic is equal to Titanic dot join ports. Okay, so what this is going to do is, it's just going to concatenate this with this data set. Okay, now what we don't need is this embark. As we have created a dummies of this embark, we don't need this value anymore. So what we are going to do is, it's Titanic dot drop.
What does
What it
this
does is,
do?
it drops the column basically. Okay, so embark is the name. Now axis is 1. Like the vertical axis is called the one axis and the horizontal is the zero axis. So we are going to remove it from the vertical axis. Now, this something is very important, in place. So what in place does is, it initializes Titanic. If we don't do in place, it will actually just print the data and not update our data set.
All
So
right.
please remember to add in place. Oh, what's this? Oh, I understand what's wrong.
You always have these times and when
Yeah,
you're
you
just
always have this
coding.
comma or a dot problem. So yeah, so
Semicolon.
now, yeah, semicolon, yeah. Now we can see Titanic.h. See, it is updated. We don't have the embark column anymore. We have embark C, embark Q, and embark S.
Okay, and what is the use of doing this?
So I told you before that machine learning models do not understand string literals. If you tell a computer what is the meaning of C, Q, and S, it does not understand it. It understands numbers. We are converting C to a number, S
All
to a
right.
number, and Q to a number, like binary. It's basically binary for machine learning.
All right, makes sense.
Okay, it makes sense. Yeah. Now you can see how it has updated. We don't have the embark column anymore because we dropped it, and we have concatenated embark C, Q, and S with our data set.
All right.
Okay. Now also one more thing. Sex played a very, very important role in Titanic because mostly the female survived. Now, as I've said before, basically a model does not understand what male or female is. Okay, so we are going to turn male and female into numbers. Basically, if it's male, it's 0, and if it's female, it's 1. Okay, so what we do is Titanic sex is equal to Titanic dot sex dot map. Male 0
Yeah.
and
So we're just saying that whenever the computer sees male, they should just assume that this is a zero digit. And whenever they see a female, that should be one, right?
Yeah. Now we are not creating dummies for this because as it's a binary data, we do not need to create a dummy. Okay, we do not need to just separate the data into three columns. It will just add to our problems. So we are just doing it in one column as it's a binary. Okay.
All right.
Okay, now what's the problem here? What's the problem? Yeah, it fixed, yeah. I don't know, it may have been some. Okay, now I understand. Sorry.
So
I
yeah,
wrote
yeah,
zero,
the problem,
I wrote zero inside.
Yeah,
sorry.
yeah, exactly. That's
I
what
wrote
I was
zero
thinking.
and
Like,
one.
is this good? Is this the right way to do it? Yeah.
Yeah, it's, yeah, I forgot. Okay, yeah, it's zero and one in, outside, yeah.
All right.
Okay, now what should we do? Yeah, next is creating our labels.
Okay.
So, we can't put our basically our weights and our labels together. So what are the weights? Weights is basically all of these columns. This passenger ID, survived, class, name. These are all the data that's used to predict our label. That
Okay.
is survive.
Yeah.
We can't keep these two data together. We need to split them apart.
Yeah.
Okay. So what we do is we do y is equal to Titanic dot survived dot copy. So it basically creates a copy and copies it to y.
Okay.
Now we can basically identify x. X, it's a basically a way to tell what x is, basically what we train on, and y is the labels. Like
okay.
we do in mapping, like ax is equal to y. Like that, x is our weights and y is our labels.
All right.
Okay, so x is equal to Titanic dot drop, just like above, just like we did, just like we dropped the embark column, we have to drop the survive.
Okay.
Because we do not need it in our x.
Yeah, this is the trained data set, right? So we don't need
yeah.
that part. Equals to true. Right. In place equals to true is very important to write, or else
I don't think
we
require with this one. I don't think because we have initialized it as x, we do not require.
Okay.
In place is required when you do not do equal to something.
All right.
Okay. In place is for something like this, where you don't put an equal to. Okay.
Got it.
So it works. Now, just like I said before, to drop the not so important features like cabin, ticket, name, and passenger ID. These do not affect a machine learning model at all because these are arbitrary data.
Yeah.
So we can just drop it. So how do we do that? Just put as before, x dot drop. Cabin.
These attributes can have an effect, but we are not experimenting with the data. We're just creating a simple model to demonstrate how a machine learning model works. What you can also do is that you can keep these attributes
and see how it
exactly
how it affects your data.
Exactly.
But through my experience, this generally just degrades our accuracy.
Okay.
You can try and experiment it. There's no harm in experimenting.
Yeah.
But through various different things, you will understand that this kind of arbitrary data just doesn't work.
Okay.
It doesn't provide any information. It just provides chaos to our data, basically. It does not help us in increasing our accuracy. It just decreases it.
Even if
and
you find one some sort of a relationship saying that cabin A people were more likely to survive, that could be a coincidence, I would say, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it could be a coincidence.
Right.
And we can use x.info to see what is there. See, we have considerably lessened our data. How, look at first how many we had 11.
Yeah.
Okay, we
Okay,
had
so
11
basically
columns.
the attributes have now gone down to 8.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, now one more important thing. There should not be any empty spaces in our data.
Okay, what does that mean?
What that means is sometimes you miss something because if you do not know the age of a person, okay, or you do not know, okay, let me give an example, let me think. Yeah, like if you don't know the P class or the sex or fair or part or something,
Yeah.
okay, you don't know the person, so they don't put it in the data set, they leave it
Okay.
as empty. Okay, and that is very dangerous to a model as it will not work.
Okay. So
Okay,
basically,
our model.
in all the people information that we have, the ones in which there is no information about them, we should just throw it out and we should not include it into
Or
our data set.
sometimes we do put it, it put mean. Okay, we put mean of everything and
Okay.
just fill that data with arbitrary things. Okay, that's another way to do it. So
All
we
right.
can see if there's anything zero in our data set by using x dot is null.
So guys, if you don't know, this is just a method that we can pass using
Yeah.
in Python. So yeah.
I'm thinking that you guys know this basic Python.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not trying to explain this because it's something that you should all know. Okay, now here it's being true.
Yeah, so basically this
Here.
means that there are certain places in which the value is zero.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so from what I remember, this let me check how to find this. Can see here the age.
Okay, what did you
Okay,
do?
this is a code. And now I can't explain what the code is. This is something that you should all know. Okay,
Yeah.
like you have to search it. Okay, I can't explain what is null is or any is. Okay, go online, search what this means. This is something that you have to do. I learned this through, I think, months and months of searching the internet and understanding what it means.
So what does this
Okay.
do? This basically just searches
Okay.
for
It's basically what it does is I'm trying to understand in an English way. So through X, we search if there is any null value and then we display it.
Okay.
Okay. It's searching for null values in our data set and when it does, it displays it.
All right.
So from here, we can
And
see
with this
that
axis equal to 1, this means that we are searching in
vertically.
yeah, exactly. If you'll do axis equal to 0, it would just search for like this, right?
One
Yeah.
row.
Yeah.
Okay, we need to see all the rows basically. We
Yeah.
do not need to see one. Okay, so we do x is equal to one. That's horizontally, vertically, sorry,
Yeah.
vertically.
All right.
Okay, so here we can see that age. Okay, age has NaN values. What NaN value means is it's not zero. It's just left empty.
Unknown. Like we
Okay,
just
yeah,
don't have any information about that.
we can either drop it. Okay, I wouldn't suggest dropping it because at first we have very less data. It's 891 only.
Yeah.
Okay, if you drop something from this such less amount of data,
So
it
generally,
will impact.
how big is a normal data set? Like you've made models,
Uh,
right? So how many
yeah,
entries does a normal data set have? Let's just
lakhs,
say
sometimes lakhs,
lakhs. Yeah, right.
23 lakhs to 50 lakhs entries are there.
That would be
Okay,
just text. That could also be images, right? If you're making some
anything. Yeah,
convolutional neural network. Yeah.
I work in computer vision, so I basically deal with images.
Yeah.
So sometimes there are basically 1 lakh images. Now,
Crazy.
it might not seem a lot, but in images, it's a basically a lot of parameters and different work that you do.
All
But
right.
that's something of later.
Here we're
Okay.
only dealing with like 890 entries, which is not a lot. So yeah.
Yeah. So what you have to do is fill the age with mean of the data set. Basically, we
Okay.
take a mean of every age and just fill it in the NaN values.
All right.
Okay. So how do we do that? X dot
So here we are having basically 177 rows out of the 891 rows that have zero
NaN
written
value.
somewhere or not NaN
Yeah,
value. Yeah.
NaN, basically NaN. X
Okay.
dot h dot mean. Now this is something that you have to know. Okay, this is attributes of panda
Yeah.
because x is a panda's data frame. So you need to know how all of this works. So it's just go online, try to understand the syntax of panda. That's very important because
Yeah.
pandas and numpy are two libraries that are used like all of the time in machine learning. Okay,
All right.
so it's better if you get comfortable with it. Okay, so if you run this, what it does is it fills these NaN values with mean. Okay, so if we run this program again,
Yeah.
it's false because
Okay.
it has filled all of the age with mean.
And what about the other data? Like you have zero written in other, you know.
That's not NaN. That's
Okay.
what I'm saying. NaN and zero is different.
All right.
Okay, zero is a value.
Okay. So zero
Okay.
is okay in a data set, but
Yeah,
NaN is
zero
not.
is okay. Zero is actually a value.
All
Okay,
right.
like
All right.
survived or lived.
Yeah.
Zero is zero can be survived. One can be dead.
Got
Zero
it.
and one are values. NaN means empty. Okay, there's a bit difference between that.
All
It
right.
might seem same, but it's not. Okay, zero is a value and NaN is empty. Okay,
Okay, bro.
and if our machine learning model sees any empty things, it won't work.
Okay.
Okay, it will give out an error.
All
So
right.
that's why we are doing this.
Okay.
Okay, now let's go to the main thing, how to train a model. Okay,
All
we are
right.
going to use sklearn.
So
From
this is the most
sklearn,
important and the most interesting part of the whole model making. We have already done the pre-processing and now we'll be taking a look at how can we create a model. And for that, we're using sklearn. Okay, so sklearn is another you know, library that you can import. And as you can see, he's importing the train test split.
What okay, I'll tell you one thing. There are three kinds of basically you can say training data sets.
Yeah.
Okay, there's X train, X validate, and X test.
Okay.
These three have three different meanings. X train is something you train your data on. Okay.
Okay.
It's something that you train. X validate is something you validate on. Okay. You try to predict the accuracy. Okay.
All right.
When you try to predict the accuracy of model, you don't predict the accuracy of something that you are seeing. Okay. Look, if you give a test, you do not give it on the same question that you have studied.
Yeah.
Right? You give it on something that's completely new. So that's what we try to do with X validate.
Right.
Okay. We try to give it something as a test. Okay. Like something very new that it does not know.
Yeah.
Okay. So we can get a real world accuracy.
Right. Makes
okay.
sense. All right.
And the X test is something that we don't have the labels to.
Yeah. We don't have the
We
information
don't
about
know.
that. And that is what this competition is all about. Okay.
Competition about
They'll have a
to
few
present.
people. So we have 891 people who we have the information about. And what about the other people? How big is the test.csv? How many entries do
Okay,
they
I
have?
have to check that. Just give me a minute. You can just add code here. Test
pd.read.csv
csv
test.csv.
Okay. And we can just do test dot shape.
Okay.
It's 480.
Okay. So we have 418
yeah.
entries over here
now,
that we'll be
see this.
tested on.
It has 11 columns and 12. This is a 12.
Yeah.
Why do you think there's one difference here? Because it does not have the survive.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
That is
it
what
does
we
not
will
have
to give, right?
Yeah. We have to give it. Yeah. We have to predict it.
Right.
Okay.
All right.
So let's go back down. From sklearn import train test split, x train comma y train. Oh, I think it's wrong. X train x valid comma y train Locality equal to train test
All right, so here we're just creating you know, various variables for the training set and the for the testing set, right? And for the validating set.
Okay, now let me explain. This is a syntax, okay? You have to understand, it first requires x train, okay, x valid,
yeah.
y train, and y valid, okay? What train test set does is, it takes x and y, and through this test size, it takes 0.2, basically,
what is test size? Okay, so
it's 0.2 into 100, basically 20%.
All right.
It takes 20% of the data and gives it to X validate.
Okay.
So 20% of the data we don't look at. It's
all
a test.
Right.
Okay, that we have to basically, you
so
understand, na?
Roughly about 160 entries will be taken away, and
yeah.
And the rest is what we'll be training it on, and then we'll try
yeah.
to validate it using that part
yeah.
of the data set. All right.
Yeah. Okay. Now let's run this.
And what does the random state mean here?
Random state, how do I explain random state? Like, it basically, it's a seeding for randomness.
Okay.
Okay. So each time you run your program, there is some randomness in the data.
All right.
It takes 20% in a very different way. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It can take 20% from top or bottom or in between.
Okay.
So each time you run your data, you do not want that there's a random chance of taking data from anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So what you do is seed that. Now, for those of you who don't understand seed is, it's basically making sure that every time you run that cell, it won't take different data as the validation set.
Okay.
Okay. It will take a fixed examples that won't change until you change the random state.
All right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's import logistic regression. So from.
Okay. So this is the model that we'll be using, guys. If you don't know, logistic regression is basically, what is the formula? Is it like 1 upon 1 plus e to the power something, right?
Yeah, it's something like that.
Yeah. So it's basically, the more negative we go, it just evens out. It's like logarithmic function. You can just look it up on Google.
It's basically like an exponential that like goes, it basically curves to a maximum and curves to a minimum.
Yeah.
It's, it does not go negative. So that's it. Okay. So we have imported logistic regression. We do model is equal to logistic regression. Now we do model dot fit x train comma y train.
Okay, and what does this does? Model dot fit.
It basically trains our machine learning model.
Okay, so this is the main part of what
yeah,
we're
doing.
Yeah, this
is the main
right?
part.
Yeah.
So as the data set is very very less, it doesn't take a lot of time.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see here.
What is this trying to tell? Increase the number of iterations, max iter.
I'm not sure about these things, but it's not an error.
Okay.
It has been done. Yeah.
It's like a suggestion to you.
Suggestion.
To use, more iterations.
Now
yeah.
we can do is model dot score. Okay. It's 80.8. That's kind of okay. And this is the main thing. We have to see what it's on validation. Okay.
Okay.
Because it's on data it has never seen before. Okay. That's the real parameters. Basically, the real way we can determine how well our model is.
Okay. What does the dot score method does?
What it does is it takes the x train.
Yeah.
Okay, and creates labels for that.
Okay.
And then it compares with y labels.
हम्म
So it basically shows that it's correct on the 80% of the labels.
ओके 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 हम्म
Okay, but that's what the score method does.
हम्म राइट
Total dot score 75%.
75%.
Okay, 0.75 means 75%. Okay, this is
हम्म
the way of showing. Okay, so now there are many different methods or ways that you can perform data analysis or data pre-processing. It goes on and on and on. You do not need to use logistic regression. There are
या
many more methods that you can do this data
या या
set on.
देर इज ऑल्सो समथिंग कॉल्ड एज सपोर्ट वेक्टर मशीन्स दैट यू कैन यूज
Yeah,
एंड
and
देर आर
random forest,
के नियरेस्ट नेबर्स इज ऑल्सो अ वे.
nearest neighbors, random forest. So there are many different ways. So you cannot generalize one method for every data set. Okay, you need to experiment. You need to get your hands dirty, basically. Okay, by experimenting on different things.
ओके
Okay, this is a
एंड व्हाट
very.
एट्रीब्यूट्स डिड वी टेक? वी टोक एज एंड
You can
द
see from
सेक्स.
above. Like this, we took P class, sex, age, SIBSP, parch, fair, and
What is
impar.
SIBSP?
You have to, I think, look it on.
Is it like siblings? Like if they have
I
siblings or
think
not?
so. It could be. Let me just check what it means.
Okay. So guys, for example, I can just tell you that if a person is from an upper class, they would have a much more likely chance to live, to survive the Titanic crash. And if they are female,
Yeah,
the chances
it's
would be
number of
even
siblings.
doubled. Yeah, like siblings, right? Yeah.
Yeah,
All right.
Parch is parents and children aboard the Titanic.
Okay.
Okay, these are jargons basically, so it's difficult to remember all of them.
Yeah. Okay, so does that mean that we have finally successfully made our first machine learning model?
Yep, we have.
All right,
Okay,
and we have
so
75% and 80% accuracy.
yeah, and that's not great at all. Okay, it
Yeah.
might seem great. But people have done 99.99
99, yeah.
accuracy. Okay, that's
They
amazing.
definitely
Okay,
have
that's amazing.
custom functions, right? Like we are just using simple logistic regression.
So you can experiment with SPM, random forest, or
Can
K
we also try
neighbors.
neural networks over here?
Oh, you know,
Why?
we don't. Neural network is not for, basically, it's much more complex. Okay, neural network basically requires more data
Yeah.
and more processing time.
Okay. So if there would have been like 10,000 people and we had information about them,
Yeah,
then it might
then
be,
this is great. That
yeah.
neural networks are great.
All
Okay,
right.
because they require more data and more time to work on. Okay,
All right.
because they have something that's epochs. That's something else altogether.
Yeah.
I don't want to go down that
We might
rabbit hole.
actually do an episode on that, guys. Like if you're
Yeah.
excited about that, make sure that you let us know in the comment section below and also hit the like button and yeah, like show the support and let me know if you have any
Yeah,
more questions.
because neural network is a rabbit hole that just goes deep and deep. You are
Yeah.
like, what does this mean? What does this mean? And it's very tough to explain in such a small time frame.
Okay, so someone is asking, Prajul, can you explain what is a recommendation engine?
What?
What is a recommendation engine? So I think he's talking about like Amazon and like
Like
how do
Amazon?
they.
Okay, that's so if you're interested in recommendation system, that comes under NLP.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm thinking you know what machine learning is and you've done it before. NLP is natural language. I think understand
Processing.
NLU. Sorry, it's NLU. Sorry,
Okay,
NLP,
okay.
NLU. Natural language understanding. So what it recommendation systems are based on that.
Okay.
So if you see Amazon, what it does is it autofills.
Yeah.
Okay. So what it does is it takes data from multiple users that have basically typed it.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So if you type, I want a table, lamp or table chair something, table chair set. Okay. If you see on Google, that's a recommendation system. It autofills data. And that's based on something millions and millions of users have used that.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's something recommendation system. You can go through it. Coursera has courses on it. And if
Yeah,
you're
yeah,
interested, you can see those courses.
yeah. All right. Guys, if you want us to create something else, like if you want us to make like a chatbot or like whatever you want to make want us to make in using machine learning, please let us know. As for sklearn, if you don't know how to learn
You can
sklearn,
just look this. You
you
can
can just
type
go to
sklearn.
YouTube. Yeah, I'll actually
Don't
show
even go
you.
to YouTube. Just type sklearn, and you will get their entire repository. Okay,
Sklearn.
and they're very well made repositories. And should I stop presenting?
Yeah, you can stop presenting.
Okay.
right? So you can just open this up, and they have a really good install guide, user guide. Okay, so the user guide is where you learn a lot, and you can just go through this. We can find logistic regression over here, and you can just start learning from it, right? So just start from the basics, linear models. I'll show you what a logistic regression looks like. Let me see if I can find it.
Photo, it's I think.
So logistic regression. So the function, yeah, as you can see, so this is the function. So the more you'll go into the negative part, it just there is like a minima, okay? And if you keep increasing, it doesn't really increase in its value. Okay, so the function, I think there should be something like this. So
an exponential.
Yeah, it's like an exponential function. Yeah, as you can see. Right, so you have e raised to power a plus bx upon 1 plus e raised to power a plus bx. Right, so this is just how logistic regression works. And let me know if you have any questions, or if you want us to make any more sort of this live streams. We have a class that we need to attend. We have a lecture in college.
Yeah.
Right now it's 6 o'clock, so that is why we'll have to end it up right now. Yeah, so thank you so much for watching, and for I hope you learned something from this. If you did, make sure
what
that
I'm going to do is Ishan, I'm going to send this link of this basically collaboratory, so you can put it in your video so everyone can see what basically we have done.
Sure. Yeah, if you have any more questions, let us know. You can also follow Prajwal. I'll leave his Instagram link in the description. If you have any doubts, you can just ask him regarding machine learning.